You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Tuesday, December 3rd, 2019. It is also the feast day of St. Francis Xavier. Now, first, before we get back to talking about Advent, let's talk about this great saint, St. Francis Xavier. Well, St. Francis was born in France, and he lived during the 1500s. He was one of the founding members of a great order that we still have in the world today, and that order has come to be known as the Jesuits. Now, St. Francis Xavier lived during a time where there were parts of this earth that had never heard the name of Jesus. And he went as a missionary to many of those places. First, he worked zealously to bring people back to Jesus in India. Next, he went to Japan, and he worked hard to convert the hearts of the Japanese. He's responsible for the first Japanese convert. And even though the faith was not well received in Japan and the church was later persecuted, he is the one that established the first Christian congregations there. He also very much wanted to go to China to spread love for Jesus there, but he was called to heaven from an illness before he got there. St. Francis Xavier was a wonderful missionary. He went out into the world to spread the love of Jesus, and we should be inspired by his example to do the same so that we aren't embarrassed to talk about Jesus to our friends that might not know him. We don't have to go to India and Japan to be missionaries. We can do it right here, right now. Now, this week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are going to start our walk through the Jesse tree for Advent. But today we are going to keep looking at the concept of Advent and what in the world it has to do with all of these characters from the Old Testament. Now, perhaps you and your family have already started doing your Jesse tree, or maybe not. But before we get there, let's talk about what the Jesse tree is. Now, the Jesse tree goes back to a Bible verse found in the book of Isaiah. And Isaiah was a prophet. And God gave him this knowledge that the Messiah, the person that would set the entire Israelite nation free from their sins and make things right with God after sin entered the world through Adam and Eve, the person that would come and do this, well, he would be born from the line of Jesse. Now, what this means is there was a Bible character named Jesse, who was the father of King David. And from his line, meaning one of his descendants, one of his great-great-great-great-great-grandsons, way down the line, that person would be the Messiah. So Isaiah gave us specifically what family this person would be born into. And we know that Jesus was that. Jesus was in the line of Jesse. So we oftentimes refer to our families as a family tree. The longer our family grows, the more branches, the more people there are on these various branches as it grows out. And that is exactly what happened with Jesse. So when we want to go walk backwards through scripture and see all of the people that led up to Jesus, then we go through the Jesse tree. We start with Adam and Eve. We go through all of his descendants, Abraham, Noah, Moses, many of the prophets. We go through them all. Now, why do we do this? Well, remember yesterday how we talked about Advent as a time of waiting? And oftentimes God asks us to wait so that he can expand our hearts so that we are better able to receive the gift he has for us. Well, that is pretty much the entire story of the Old Testament. The Old Testament is a story of God revealing himself to the Israelites and preparing them slowly to receive him. Now, after Adam and Eve sinned in the garden, things went terrible. The Israelites were constantly walking away from God and worshiping false gods, and God would have to punish them. This went on and on and on. And so God repeatedly sent prophets to them to tell them to turn from sin, that sin would be punished, to accept God's mercy and to prepare for the Messiah. And so with each of these prophets, the people of God, the Israelite nation, took one tiny step closer to being prepared to receive Jesus. That is the story of the Old Testament. So if you find these 4 weeks of Advent hard to sit and patiently wait through to receive Jesus at Christmas, remember that the Israelites waited for generations and generations and hundreds upon hundreds of years. They lived a life of waiting, and we only have to wait 4 weeks. So starting tomorrow, we are going to look through the Jesse tree, but we are going to do this by looking at God's prophets. Not every person in the Jesse tree is a prophet. In fact, most of them aren't. But we are going to look at the people specially chosen by God to bring his specific message to the people. There are a lot of good stories, and we are going to be talking about some pretty well-known characters from the Old Testament. So we will be starting that tomorrow. But for today, what I want to do is I want to take one step further with what we did yesterday. So yesterday, I challenged you to get your Advent wreath set up. Today, I challenge you to light the first candle, whether it just be for a little while or all day. And again, it can be a real candle or a battery-operated candle or a picture of a candle, whatever you want, but light that first candle. This is the way that we count down the time to Christmas, but also lighting candles is a beautiful symbol for what happens during Advent. We start in the darkness, and then we get a little bit of light. God is coming into the world slowly. Next week, we'll light another candle, just a little bit more light. The light of God is slowly entering the world. And by the end, when we have all 4 candles lit, God's light is fully present. So my challenge for you, light that first candle.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow. But until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Hey there, Sprouts. As you likely noticed, we will be talking about the Jesse tree during Advent. If you are looking for a great resource to use in your family or in your classroom to go through the various characters of the Jesse tree, I invite you to check out the booklet from Catholic Sprouts. You can find the details for it in the notes for this podcast episode.